When your business location has multiple rooms and you need to differentiate them in the software, you will want to use the Rooms and Resources setting. This is not to be confused with the Room Rentals option, which allows you to rent your rooms out to other businesses or teachers and charge them. For information on that feature, please see our related articles section below. In this video, we'll show you how to enable the Rooms feature, explain the options available on the Rooms and Resources screen, and lastly, demonstrate how to assign a room for a class, enrollment, and appointment. Before you can begin accessing the Rooms feature, it will need to be enabled. Go to Home and then Manager Tools. Click the Settings button on the top right, and then choose General Setup and Options on the lower left under General Settings. Click on the System Settings tab to expand the menu. Scroll down and check the box for number 11, Resource Scheduling, to enable it, and click the Update button at the top to save the change. After clicking Update, some additional settings will appear, which you may also need to enable. For this example, we'll be enabling number 12, Resources for Classes and Enrollments, and number 13, Resources for Appointments. The remaining options are used for room rentals, so we won't go over them here. For further information on those options, please see our articles below. We'll choose Update again at the top to save. Now that the feature is enabled, indicated by the appearance of the Room Schedule tab, we can manage the Rooms and Resources screen. To access this Rooms and Resources screen, click the Home tab and then Manager Tools. Click the Settings button on the top right and select Rooms and Resources on the top left under Business Settings. Rooms and Resources is split up into two tabs, visible on the left, Manage Rooms and Room Requirements for Appointments. We'll look at this Manage Rooms section first. Here, you'll see a list of your previously added rooms. To add a new room, click the Add a Room button on the top right. Enter the name of your room and the locations where it can be booked. Then, choose whether it can be used for all services or only specific ones. If you select all of the service types, but none of the services, then this room will be able to be used for all of those services. This saves you time, since you won't need to check every single service individually. However, for example, if you want the room to only be used for yoga classes, you'll want to choose only specific services, then classes in the service type section, and then Yoga in the Services section. When finished, click the Save button to add the room. Clicking on the gear on the right of the room will give you the options to show this room on the Room Schedule PDF, deactivate the room, and delete the room. If Show on Room Schedule PDF is enabled, this room will appear on the Scaled or Paged PDF on the Room Schedule tab. Deactivating the room will place it under the View and Active Rooms section at the bottom. Deleting a room will permanently remove it, but this is only possible if the room has never been used before. To edit your room options, click on the room name to expand the settings. All of the previous settings you could change when first adding the room are still available here to be changed. In addition, you may click and drag the icon on the left in order to rearrange the order of these rooms. This changes the order that the rooms appear on the Room Schedule tab. Now, let's take a look at the Room Requirements for Appointments page under Rooms and Resources on the far left. This screen allows you to require rooms to be selected for specific services before they can be booked. This helps prevent appointments from being double booked in situations when you have limited resources available. Once you enable room to be booked for an appointment service on the Manage Rooms tab, it will appear on this page. However, making rooms a requirement for booking is optional. Only the appointment types you select here on this page will have a room requirement. If you leave them all blank, none of them will require rooms. If double booking appointments is not a concern for your business, you can ignore this screen. Now that we know how rooms can be added and changed, let's assign a room to a class. Click on the Classes tab at the top to view your schedule. The uppermost class on our schedule does not have a room assigned, as we can see under the Room column. To assign one, we'll click on the class name. At the bottom of the page, to the right of the Rooms option, we'll select the room we want from the drop-down menu, and then choose Assign a Room. The room will be assigned to this class instantly, and we do not need to save. We'll head back to the Classes tab to see how we can change a room after it's been added to a class. The other class for Monday already had a room assigned. The best way to change it is to click on the gear icon on the far right and choose Change Room. This will bring us to the Make Schedule Change screen, where we can select the new room or check for room conflicts. This screen allows us to change the room on a temporary or permanent basis by changing the drop-down at the top and the start and end date filters. Choosing Check Room Conflicts will bring us to the Room Allocation Report. Here, you can select the room you want to assign and see if it's being used for any overlapping dates. You can click Return to Make Schedule Change at the top to return to the previous screen. When you've finished making changes, click the Submit button. The other way of changing the room is to simply click Clear All Rooms on the Edit Scheduled Class/Event screen, where the room was initially assigned, and then choose a different room using the drop-down menu. This method gives you less control over when this room will be used. So, if you change the room here, it will update for all previous and future instances of this class. You won't be able to make a temporary change or permanent from date forward change using this method. Also, clicking Make Room Change on this screen will bring you to the same Make Schedule Change page that choosing Change Room on the gear did. Now, let's assign a room to an enrollment. Click on the Enrollments tab, then click on the name of the enrollment. The only difference between classes and enrollments in terms of assigning rooms is that there's no gear icon like there is on the Class tab, which means that there's no Change Room shortcut. Otherwise, the process is identical to assigning a room to a class. Select the room using the drop-down menu and click the Assign a Room button to add it. To remove it, you can click Clear All Rooms and select a different room from the drop-down. You can also click Make Room Change, which will bring you to the Make Schedule Change screen, where you can choose to make a temporary or permanent room adjustment. Lastly, let's assign a room to an appointment. Click on the Appointments tab and click on an available space on your appointment schedule. The Resource option is where we'll select the room. When we try booking a service that requires a room, an asterisk will appear next to the Resource option. This indicates that a room is required. Since a room is not required for this service, we can leave this blank and still book the appointment. Feel free to view our related articles section below for further information on any of the features or steps we covered in this video.